not believe your eyes.
Good morning, everybody. We are back. Happy Veterans Day. You are listening on Friday, but I'm recording it on Veterans Day 11/11. So happy Veterans Day. Shout out to all my veterans out there. We appreciate you. I appreciate you. Pretty good week. It flew right by. They keep flying right by. I tell you what, it's the holiday season. I got my Christmas decorations up already. Shout out the Puerto Rican princess for that. College basketball season again. Shout out my West Virginia Mountaineers. We got college football, college basketball coinciding at the same time. It's great. Cold weather, long beards, chest hair popping out of the shirt. Great time of year. Let's go. Shout out, got two Greg's birthdays this week. Happy birthday to the Schwarf and happy birthday to Hambone. Keep grinding. We're old men, but we are still kids at heart. Keep grinding. So today on the menu we got a new one. I've never seen this. Some of you may have seen it. I have not. I am not a Bang drinker, but I got a Bang today. Bang cookies and cream high protein coffee. Let's give it a try. Let's give it a nice try. Cheers. Smells very good. You know what this smells like, to be honest? It smells like you just poured yourself a nice bowl of Cookie Crisp. That's what it smells like. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. This is delicious right here. Cookies and cream craze Bang. No free ads. Wow.
Wow.
That is delicious. All right, so last Thursday, the Eternals premiered. And of course, I do not miss the premiere. I go the first showing, the first day it's out. I'm tired of getting everything spoiled for me. With all that being said, I will be completely honest with you guys. I, myself, for me personally, did not have high expectations for this movie. I didn't know much about the heroes. I never read the comic books. From my TikTok insiders, some of their reviews weren't that good. So I didn't personally have high expectations. But I went in with an open mind, all right? I went in with an open mind, and good thing I went in with an open mind, because I absolutely loved the movie. I loved it. It's one of my favorite newer Marvel movies to come out. The Eternals give me like a Marvel Green Lantern vibe. Like they're kind of like the Green Lanterns of the Marvel universe. Spoilers ahead. So if you haven't seen it yet and you don't want to get it spoiled, spoilers ahead. You have been warned. My boy Icarus from the beginning gave me major Homelander vibes. From the very beginning. Something was off about him. And you know, my intuition never fails me. I was correct. So we have all these new characters. The Celestials, just how big they were. The graphics of the movie were great. I loved it. I recommend it. Don't need to know that much of what has already happened. It's kind of like a standalone new story film. So shout out Eternal. Shout out Marvel. Last Sunday, Yellowstone premiere. 2-episode premiere. 2-hour long premiere. That first hour was about as action-packed as it comes. The first 15 minutes had me pouring a beer on a Sunday night. I poured me a nice tall glass of beer and was just watching all this action-packedness going on. They even gave us a sneak peek at our boy Tim McGraw in 1883. Comes out in December as well. Back in the year 1883, where the Dutton Ranch started. Cowboys, Indians, guns, horses, fighting, all this shit. Good action-packed stuff. I suggest you watch Yellowstone. If you don't want to restart it, if you don't feel like catching up, I suggest watching 1883 when it comes out in December. Shout out my boy Kevin Costner, and shout out most of all my boy Cole Hauser, aka Rip Wheeler. Absolute stud, absolute smoke show of a man. Keep grinding. Can't wait for this week's episode. So tomorrow, today actually, when this is released, November 12th, 2021 is Disney Plus Day. Now, there's rumors, speculations, but what are rumors and speculations anymore? You get rumors and speculations about everything that exists in the world and then nothing happens, okay? But anyway, rumors and speculations that there's a Star Wars trailer going to be released on Disney Plus Day, and you're like, what kind of Star Wars trailer could it be? Is it another Boba Fett trailer? Is it a new show? Is it one of the new Disney Plus shows trailer? Well, I'll tell you what trailer it's going to be. It's going to be the Obi-Wan Kenobi trailer. We're going to hear Darth Vader's breath. We're going to see some freaking lightsaber action. I can't wait. Most anticipated show, perhaps of all time for me. I don't know if my heart will be able to stand this. My heart just may give out of excitement of being dangerously caffeinated with all my shows that I love. So we'll see tomorrow. We'll see today. We'll see December 12th. We'll see November 12th. Today, if we get a good Star Wars trailer, we'll see if maybe we'll get the Spider-Man trailer too. I can't wait. Stay tuned. You'll hear about it next week. All right, Travis Scott, at his thing, Astroworld, I believe it's called. Astroworld. I don't know much about these rappers, to be honest. I just saw what I saw on TikTok, you know, the number one news app, TikTok. Some of the most bone-chilling videos I've ever seen. I'm gonna be honest, you know, I don't know much about any of these guys. But I saw his apology video. I saw how he reacted during people screaming during the show. Yes, granted, there's millions of freaking thousands and thousands of people. I'm sure it's loud. I'm sure you can't hear much. It looked like a freaking satanic ritual is what it looked like, with his stage, with that eyeball, with the big portal looking thing, upside down cross stuff going on. And then I saw his apology video. You know, 8 people on record died at Astroworld. Probably more, to be honest. I saw his apology video, and this is where I was like, you know what, this guy's a scumbag. His apology video, you know, it didn't show much sincerity at all. He looks like he's just stoned, you know, rubbing his face, like, in his mind thinking, oh, I don't really care, like, my lawyers are making me do this. It's a disgrace. I don't think we'll be seeing much of Travis Scott anymore. I could be wrong. I'm wrong about a lot of things, but, you know, it's hard to even put into words how terrible, how bone-chilling some of the footage I saw was, you know, jam-packed in there. You have people literally screaming for your lives. It's right there on video. I mean, I could go on and on about it, but I'm not, you know. RIP to all of those who lost their lives at Astroworld. Just Travis Scott, you're kind of a scumbag, so don't mean to be in such a somber mood, but also RIP to our weatherman, Dave Walker. He was the weatherman our entire life on News 7. I think it was News 7. You know, he retired. He was about to move down to Mexico and get some Mexico action going on down there. And just a few weeks after he retired, he died. I'm sure he went straight up to heaven, so RIP to Dave Walker. To lighten the mood a little bit, we got our West Virginia Mountaineers basketball is back. We are back. I love my guy, Huggy Bear. Our team is going to be nice, a lot of talent. I'm intrigued to see who's going to take the reins as the leader position of the team. You know, we have our Javon Carters. We have our Deshaun Butlers. We have our Deuce McBrides. I don't know who our leader is going to be yet. Is it Taz Sherman, Sean McNeil, Gabe, my boy Gabe? Today, Friday, November 12th, is the Backyard Brawl at 8:30 p.m. I will be watching. I will be wearing my Javon Carter jersey, screaming at the TV at the top of my lungs, enjoying myself. It's going to be a great season. Stay tuned tonight, 8:30, Backyard Brawl, Eat Shit Pit. As those say sometimes, let's go Mountaineers. Quote of the day.
I don't have the energy anymore to be anything other than who I am. Fuck it, dude.
Let's go Mountaineers. I'd like to make myself believe.